White Crane Switch Down. It's actually the work was created abstractly, so I didn't think about the title when I made the work. I just I tend to work from my feeling, and especially through COVID, I had those sort of, you know, we were all a bit down and we were sort of isolated and so on. So when I went to the studio, I had the feeling that my work was going to be monochromatic. Normally it's full of colour. This work is just monochromatic, because I think that was the mood that I was sort of portraying. And also the sort of stress that we all had was meaning that I wanted to express that kind of frustration, if you will. So I was kind of moving the paint, you know, all around and doing all these sort of things, you know. And then I thought, oh, gee, that's working, you know. And when I finished it and it was drying, I was looking at it and I thought, gee, sort of reminds me of all these birds in flight, you know. And then I remembered my time when I was studying Tai Chi here in Sydney with a Chinese master, and we did a lot of the Tai Chi form, and there was one sweeping movement, you know, like this, where he said, oh, this one's called White Crane Sweeps Down, you know? And I thought, wow, perfect title, you know, it's exactly what I see there. And as soon as I heard from Rudy that this exhibition was on, I thought, well, that's the ideal thing to put in, because it's got the Chinese theme, and being monochromatic, I think it's in graphics, it's the sort of thing that Chinese people relate to. Because I do like that style of working with just black and white.
Yeah. So what do you think is the most challenging aspect of visualizing a memory or idea? And when does the confidence of, I'm going to paint this, or this is worth painting, come into play?
Yeah, it's an interesting question. I think all artists, you know, they struggle with the starting. And some people, you know, that's what holds them up most, you know. So for me, I tend to have an idea when I go into the studio, and then I start to play around with it and see what kind of results I get. And if it's not working for me at that time, I'll go to another canvas, say, and work on that, you know. And that way I get through that aspect of struggling to come up with themes and ideas and things like that, because it's often difficult, you know? But I think it's all down to you want to express an idea or an emotion, so you just feel that and go with that, you know, and then see what comes out of it. Sometimes it's not very successful, and other times it's bad.